Okay guys, I have to abort the track submits. I just got a phone call. There are some urgent things I have to take care of. Today, no coffee, just a bagel with cheese. I don't know if this really counts as healthy, but that's all we have at home. And it's already a big advantage that I'm not eating snacks for breakfast. And that I'm eating anything at all before heading to the studio. I'm looking for the other glove. Can't find it, so no gloves today, but closing the jacket up until to the end. Okay. I feel like I could be now part of South Park, like this canny guy that gets killed every episode. Just instead of getting killed every episode, I would be the guy that actually never appears. Because I would be the guy that just disappears in his studio and spending most of the time just making new tracks. Okay, so first of all, today on the agenda is taking care of some organizational things for the remix contest. I'm really looking forward to it, and today I can actually announce that the contest is starting on Friday. So on Friday you will be able to download the remix stems, import them into your DAW and just get started, and I can't wait to hear your first versions of the track. Really, really excited about it. The only downside today is that I'm probably stuck for the entire day taking care of emails. I didn't answer any on Saturday or on Sunday, and I have to change two contracts, send them out to singer and songwriters. 3 or 4 phone calls are waiting, and I have to plan some recording session things for next week. And I also got a ton of track submits. It's actually amazing if you just log onto the plays that my videos get compared to how many track submits I get. The ratio is just insane. So there are a lot of really creative producers watching my videos that are extremely productive. Some of you even send me 2, 3, or 4 tracks a month. That's just amazing. So let's pick maybe 3, 4, or 5 of these tracks and do the next edition of track submits. Okay guys, it's time to pick again one random track. I would just scroll up and down the emails and just stop somewhere. This track is by Niels. He's 17 years old and from Bremen, which is here in Germany, pretty close by. He's making house music and has worked on his new track. His artist name is Panda and the track is called Forest. It's a really cool groovy track. I like the main synth. It's sounding cool. It has a certain groove to it. It definitely would work in a club. What I'm missing are more high frequency elements, or just making them a little bit louder. Also, the main synth, it needs definitely some stereo processing. It's very mono. It's sitting in the middle, and since there are not really a whole lot of other elements going on, the dimension in the mixing is missing a bit. So try widening the main sound or adding or layering sounds that are just wider than this one single sound that is sitting in the middle. But let's just get to the next track submit. It's by Brady. He's 15 years old and living in Austin, Texas. He's been messing around with music for the past, and he now made his first serious track, or actually his second track. He feels like the intro is lacking something. Feedback would be nice. So yeah, let's just listen to it. I mean, for 15 years, this is really already impressive. I think, no, I didn't do any productions with 15, but the track is from the arrangement a bit boring. It's one constant loop going throughout the entire track. You need a lot more diversity, a lot more change, changing the melodies, changing the sounds, having bigger breaks, changing the drums a whole lot more. Also, the main sound is a bit too loud, and I'm really missing a kick. If you just raise your kick by 2, 3, or even 4 dB, and maybe lower the sub bass by 1 or 2 dB, you will have a lot more impact on the low end, because on most tracks it's actually the kick that is giving the sub bass part instead of having a real sub bass. It of course depends on the musical style, but in most tracks it's actually the kick really pushing it. I see this mistake quite a lot. I think I should just probably do a tutorial on how to place your kick, how to EQ it, how to get the right loudness, and also how to get it into the key of the track so that it actually sounds good together with the chords and notes you're playing. I will now stop the track, submit, take care of all of the business things. They are my main priority for today, and I want to get all of it done. There is no way I want to deal with it again tomorrow or tomorrow. I want to be able to come here and just work on music. You know, guys, it's now almost 10. That's exactly what happens if I don't work for 2 days, don't take care of business and email stuff. And I just spent here almost 12 hours. My computer is still at the same spot, and I didn't do any music at all, which is probably just the worst feeling in the world, to sit in a studio in front of speakers and not even use them. I'm now actually meeting with Gordon. We have to discuss a couple of music business things. I don't know if you knew, but he studied for a couple of years music business. And I think he's right now writing his bachelor thesis or something like that. But I need some advice from him with one of my contracts. This always happens. Whenever I film in the car, I put the camera here, and the smarts, they're so curvy and slippery. Maybe it's just my driving style, who knows. Yeah, that's good. Ciao. I need one of these things that you can just put onto the window, like a Saugnapf, I don't know, a suction cup. Yes, it's called suction cup. I need one of those for the cars and a light. Ah! I usually edit all of the camera falls out when I do shoots in cars, but today, why not leave them in? It's a little behind the scenes of filming a vlog. If you think I'm always late, Gordon is like 10 times worse, 10 times at least. And now his phone is off. His phone is really off. Now I have to get out of the car and go to his door and ring the bell. That's so old school. Gordon just really made me get out of the car and help him with stuff I absolutely hate. But now you have to help me with contract stuff.
I sure will do. And at least you get some exercise, huh?
Yes, there are some people that suggest that I exercise more. Are you done with your bachelor?
I'm actually still working on the last couple of pages, but it's like a slightly
it's always the same topic. The last 10%. Yeah.
Now, in general, it's working out. And
what's the topic? Is there any way you can translate it into
absolutely
English?
It's music industry 4.0. It's about strategic and operative implementations through digital transformation in music industry.
Sounds basically really interesting. He sent me like one page to check if I can understand anything. I couldn't even read the first sentence. Next up, probably just beer.
Yeah, grab a beer.
Feierabendbier, that's a term you have to learn in German.
Sure. Whoa. Danke.
Okay. We had, I don't know, 6, 7 drinks?
6, 7. Somehow. Yeah.
Now walking back home and continuing the track submits. Special edition drunk trip. Drunk trip submits.
Yeah.
I got here another track. It's from I'm Joffrey, and he is following me already for 6 months, watching the videos. That's good. He started in 2011. He's just interested in some general feedback, so let's hit the play button. So do it all. Amazing track. I don't even know what to say. The vocals are cool. I like the ambience. I like the style. I like the direction. Maybe the only thing I would change are these pitched vocal bits. I personally don't really like them, but that's actually not the issue. The thing is, there are some points in the track where they play at the same time with the main vocal. And I think it's a bit distracting from the vocals, so just lower it maybe a bit or just leave it out entirely and leave more room for the great vocals. Okay, before doing the next one, I actually already started cooking a bit in the kitchen. It's like 2 in the morning. Vanessa isn't here, so no problem making tomato sauce and spaghetti. It's actually not spaghetti, it's these butterfly farfalla things. And of course a lot of parmesan. Maybe just a tiny bit more. Please don't tell me that eating this that late is not healthy, I know. But I didn't have any time to eat anything except for the bagel this morning. So while I am enjoying my dinner, let's just listen to the last track for today. This one was also a nice track called Serenity by Lucas, aka Mondano. He's 17 years old, is now producing for 3 years using Fruity Loops, and is interested in a general feedback and how much he needs to improve to get the track released. I think the mixing is quite alright. The kick is nice, the bass is there, you have the pad sound. The pad sound is a bit overwhelming. It's not really leaving space for the other elements to breathe, so maybe lower it on the volume. And there is a second melody in the background, maybe push that a bit more in the foreground and have it as the main thing in the track. But other than that, that's already heading into the right direction. How long he will need to improve to get a release, I actually can't say. It depends on how many hours you put into making music a day. Maybe half a year or a year. I've definitely heard worse that already had a release, but there's not really a point in releasing tracks that aren't really 100% good, because they won't make you anything. You really have to wait to a certain point to be good enough to release it. But I also know a lot of people that just wait way too long until they think they're perfect in production. It's important not to release too early and not too late. Kind of hit the point in between where you make tracks where you're not ashamed of in maybe a year or in two, and that are still kind of connected to your artist name and your style. If you change your styles too often, that's actually hurting you. If your quality isn't good enough, it's a bit embarrassing if people go back your tracks and listen to them. But I think actually no one does that. But maybe you guys should do it. I think in another video I explained that this is probably the most motivational thing you can do. Just pick your favorite artist and check him out on Beatport and go back to the very first track they ever released. You will be impressed or astound what you will actually hear. A lot of producers that are now big names have actually started with really weak and bad tracks. But yeah, enough. That's it for today. It's late. It's time to go to bed. I have an appointment early in the morning and yeah, I need to sleep. Whenever I pass by this place on my way back home, it always smells like an Amsterdam. Very funky.